Hello everyone, my name is Rajesh and I'm VP of Engineering at Ashling. So Ashling provides products and services for embedded development, including IDEs, debuggers, compilers, SDKs, and hardware debug and trace probes. So today I'll be giving a very quick overview of our new debug and trace probe, Vitra-XS. Vitra-XS is a universal debug and trace probe for different architectures, including RISC-V and ARM. And it supports non-intrusive real-time tracing. Let us now switch to my screen and see Vitra-XS in action.
This is a setup I have here today. On this Digital RT100T board, we have the Sci-Fi E61 core running and emitting trace data via this P-mode connectors. And this is Ashling in-house adapter to convert the P-mode trace data to the Micta one. And the Ashling Vitra-XS is connected via the Micta cable to this board and then via the USB port to the host machine. On the host PC, I have the Ashling RISC-V ID running. RISC-V ID is an Eclipse-based ID from Ashling for the embedded application development and debugging. Let us now switch to the Ashling RISC-V ID. This is the Ashling RISC-V ID and we have a simple project loaded here and built and ready to be downloaded to the target. For downloading this application, let us take the debug configurations. And here you can see the application, the ELF file has been chosen. In the debugger tab, the debug probe has been auto-detected and the target device has been selected as a Sci-Fi E-core. In the startup tab, we are mentioning to load the image to the target. And in the trace tab, we are enabling trace, obviously. And this Sci-Fi Insight is chosen as a trace architecture, which is the Nexus trace. And we have two tabs, one for capture settings and one for producer settings or the emitter settings. Within capture settings, we have the on-chip trace and off-chip trace. The on-chip where the trace data is stored on the onboard buffer, and the off-chip trace where the trace data is emitted via the pins. So we choose off-chip trace, we are using Vitra-XS. And then within Vitra-XS, again, we have two options. One is to capture to the Vitra-XS buffer. Vitra-XS comes with its own trace buffer of 512 MB. And the other option is to stream to host, where the data is streamed to host directly, real time. And the other options, we can leave them as default. And we'll just take a quick look at this probe interface block configuration as well, where we mentioned the width of data and all. So the 4-bit is what is now being emitted, so I'm choosing 4-bit data here. The other options you can see here, including the SWD, Manchester, UART options. Clock reference model, we have the center and edge, so the currently it is configured for center, so I'm choosing center here. Likewise, producer settings is all we can leave. Everything as default. You can see the different options here, like the HTM and sync without optimization is selected here. And the maximum trace messages between sync messages is again an optimum value of 256 is chosen here. So all this, with all these settings, when I press debug, we are actually downloading the program to the target via the Vitra-XS and the program is run to main. And now the program is now run to main and now we can see the actual trace working. So I'll just run my program to a single location, this breakpoint. The breakpoint has been taken. And now let us fetch the trace data. The moment I press this fetch button, the trace data is decoded and is now displayed in the trace view. So we can see the entire program flow here, the address information, the opcode information, the disassembly information, and the source level information. So let us go to the last trace. So I'm pressing the last page option here. So you can see the last trace here. And you also have this playback option, which means on the trace view, if I'm pressing my arrow keys, you can see the trace program flow being displayed here. So like that way we can understand the entire program flow just by pressing the arrow keys, which functions are executed, which piece of line is not executed or executed. So that's how easy it is to configure and fetch and capture and view trace data using Vitra-XS. Having said that, I am now terminating my session.
Thank you for watching the video. For more details or queries, follow the links I mentioned in the screen. Thank you.